H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Today, let's start with thread.sleep. Thread.sleep, this is a internal to Java, okay, which is available within by default Java. So the use of this thread.sleep is for wait. Okay, basically it is for wait in the sense, say for example you have entered username, password, it is done signing, okay, home page is appearing, say home page is appearing after 10 seconds, okay, so this 10 seconds, we have to make our script to wait for 10 seconds, that can be achieved using this thread.sleep, okay, we have to mention thread.sleep 10,000 and semicolon. Here this 5,000 or 10,000 is in terms of milliseconds, okay, this 5,000 is millisecond, okay, so the mainly we use thread.sleep is to make our script to write, and probably we can say it is like to be in sync with our script, okay. Well, you get more details of this thread.sleep, I mean what is the technical use of this as part of synchronization concept. As of now, in simple words, to make our script to write for some time to be in sync with the application, we use thread.sleep. Okay. So why we have discussed over here, because here if you close the grid, here we said thread.sleep. Basically what will happen if we use thread.sleep, when we are executing our script in the background, okay, again in terms of operating system level, there will be one thread will be created. I mean to say a process will be created. See, you know, when you use this thread.sleep, of course not this thread.sleep, basically when you execute your script, basically when you execute your Java program, okay, in the background, in the operating system level, there will be a process, a thread or process will be created. Okay. So when I say thread.sleep, we are making this process to wait for 5 seconds. Okay. Technically, when I say thread.sleep, okay, from our script, we are making our operating system level thread to wait for 5 seconds. Okay. So say what will happen, say because of some operating system issue or because of some issue, this thread got crashed, okay, say this thread got crashed because of some issue, okay, I mean because of some issue, say because of unavailability of the processor or because of some XYZ issue, okay. Okay, because of some issue, say our thread got corrupted or it is going to be interrupted. In that case, our Java program is going to be uninterruptedly, our Java program is going to be end without any proper end. Okay, what I'm saying, I've been talking about 3D. Now let me show what I'm talking about. Now see here, public void use of thread. This is the method name. Okay. Now here I'm saying I want to use thread. Now, everyone observe, basically this highlighted line is going to help us, it is going to wait for five seconds. Okay. Why? As I said, thread means it is operating system level related. So, because of that, while executing the script, so whatever the processor or whatever the process, whatever the thread that making us to execute our script, so by using this, the process itself is going to wait for 5 seconds. That is the ultimate concept. But however, here there might be an issue, there might be a problem. Because of the problem, this thread.sleep, this particular, this may got failed. Because this thread.sleep may fail. Again, because of this, this entire script, maybe this entire method, use of thread, okay, this is the method, may got failed. Okay, unexpectedly or what I can say, suddenly and without having any proper end, it is going to be end. Okay, so basically pure Java program is not going to accept that. But however, we are using editor, right? So here itself it is saying that, see here, it is showing some error message here, some kind of a red color here. It is showing a red color underline. It means the Java editor, this Eclipse is not itself is not allowing us to write it directly like this, thread.sleep. Why? Because it seems to be a kind of a risky logic. Okay. It seems to be a risky logic in the sense, if this thread got corrupted, we are not sure how our program is going to be executed. So, as our editor identified that, here you are using a kind of a risky logic, you have to handle it. Everyone try to understand my statement. So, whenever you have a risky logic, okay, like this, thread.sleep is a, we understood the use, that is okay. But now I am talking about the next level of this, okay. Basically, I am talking about a concept called exception, okay. So, here what I am saying, say, if we use this thread.sleep, it seems to be a risky logic. Okay, if the thread got crashed, we will not sure how our program is going to behave. In that case, we have to make sure that our script is going to handle that. Okay, so we have to give a proper end. Either we have to give a proper end, or at least we have to handle that. Okay, so exceptions. It is to handle the risky logic, and here there are two ways. One is by just throwing error by using try catch. Okay, for those people who know Java, I probably you might have know this, and apart from this I know there will be try catch finally, but here in terms of Selenium we don't go with those things. Okay, we will not use try catch finally. But however, in simple, here we use two ways. One is by just throwing an error. It means, say if you have any risky logic, okay, our script basically got stopped, and basically Java itself, it is not going to allow if you have any risky logic. We have to handle it two ways. One is by mentioning that it is going to throw an error. We have to say that for the Java that this is the logic, I am using a logic. Because of that logic, probably this may throw an error. Okay. Or you can handle it. Now everyone up there. Now I mentioned thread.sleep. Now if I keep my cursor over here, everyone up there, it is saying add throws declaration are surrounded with try catch. It is showing two solutions here itself. Now if you see here add throws declaration, if you observe this method is saying that throws interrupted exception. Okay, again exceptions means there are some different types of exceptions. Okay, so here because of this thread, if thread got disturbed or it got interrupted, it is going to throw an interrupted exception. Here we are exclusively mentioning it one type of exception. So here we know, here directly it is giving a type of exception. So for example, sometimes it is not going to give any exception. In that case, simply use exception. You don't try to understand this. I will explain again about this, but simply I am trying to use, if I want to use this thread.sleep, my Java editor itself is not allowing me to write it. So it is giving two solutions. One is throwing exception. Again, we'll come back to this. A simple thing is throwing an exception. So what is the use of this one means? Before execution of itself, our Java editor, interpreter, I mean whatever the software that it is going to understand our Java program. Okay, in the background, this Java runtime environment. Okay, that is going to be, basically that is going to understand the Java program. So before executing itself, the Java runtime environment will have an idea that, okay, in this program, there is a kind of a risky logic is there. So it will be ready with any kind of exceptions. Okay, of course, if any exception comes in, it will simply properly, it will throw that error and it will properly stop the scripts. Okay, this is one way of handling. The other way is like, see here again I am using thread.sleep, and if I say again some 3000, okay. Now here again it is showing this error. Now here one of the ways you can simply say that throws exception, and here see here I can be surrounded with try catch. It means if you observe here, try means in this try block we will keep the risky logic here. This is a risky logic, so we kept this risky logic in this try block. Okay, if some error, if any error got occurs, okay, because of this line, this error will be cached here. Okay, because of this line, if any error has been occurred, if any error occurred, that error will be captured. That error will be cached here. Okay. So basically it is exclusively saying that interrupted exception. It means because of this logic, so it has thrown some interrupted exception. So we are going to catch only interrupted exception. Okay. It is going to catch only interrupted exception. Okay. If because of this line, if any interrupted Java is going to throw any interrupted exception, that error will be captured over here. It will be catched over here, and then here we can write some logic here. So if by somehow if we can handle that, okay, here you can write a handling logic. It means by some way if you can handle that logic, you can write that handling logic over here. Okay. And here e print stack trace means we are basically printing the because of this error, because of this, basically the error has been occurred. Okay, so we are trying to print what that error related message over here. E print stack trace means it is going to save the error related information. Okay, basically here our purpose is strict. If you know any by some way, if you can handle that, we can write a handling logic here. Okay, so sometimes we use this try catch block. Okay, generally in validation purpose we use this try catch block. Okay, so here in two simple ways, if you have any risky logic here, either you can use the throws exception. So your before executing itself, a Java runtime environment will know that there is a risk logic, so make sure there might be some error. Okay, so if an error occurs, it will simply in a proper way it is going to stop the script. Okay, if you use this try catch block, you are going to mention the risk logic over here and a relative handling mechanism, handling logic you are going to write here. Okay, here if you remember, if you see here, so say add throws exception, by default it is saying interrupted exception. It seems because of this error, because of this, there might be a probable error. There's a probability that because of this, the probable error might be interrupted exception. Okay, it is something like, say, what is the mobile that you have? I mean, say instead of that, say. Do you have a mobile? I mean to say here, I can say simply mobile, or I can say simply a Samsung mobile, iPhone mobile. Okay, even I can mention some model two. Now something like this, if you see here. I can simply say that a mobile, say I have a mobile. I can also say that I have a HTC mobile, I have a Samsung mobile. I can simply say that I have a mobile, or I can, in other words, I can say I have a Samsung mobile, I have an iPhone mobile. Okay, in other words, here you can mention exclusively here interrupted exception, this one. And in our Selenium, basically in our Selenium, there will be the probable error most of the times is no such element exception. Basically, this is the exception which is related to Selenium. Whenever I'm trying to find an object is presented or not in the application, say I want to see whether a logout link is presented in the application or not. Okay, if that link is not there in the application, it is going to throw an exception. This no such element exception, no such element found exception. Okay, so interrupted exception, there are so many other exceptions. Okay, here you will have the types. If you don't want to mention exclusive type here, you can simply mention exception. That is what I have done earlier. So here, instead of mentioning exclusive or exact type here, I can simply mention exception, simply like this. Still it is okay. Okay, so we are saying that here there is a problem, or I can say that here there is an interrupted exception problem, something like this. Now see here, before I start with Webdriver interface, we should understand what is meant by interface. Okay, interface, again that is related to Java concept. Okay, interface means it's a skeleton of a class. Okay, it's a skeleton of a class. For example, we have been talking about car, right? Okay, let me complete this. It's a skeleton of a class. Here we just declare, every observer declare the methods. Everyone try to understand, we just declare the methods. It means we will not define them. What I hope everyone know the difference between declare and define. Okay. When I say here declare means here we have just mentioned that in this interface we just declare them. We are not going to write the internal logic. So declare is something like this. Say if I mention here public void method 1. That's it. I will not write anything over here. I will not write anything within that. Okay. I will not write within this method. I will not write anything. This is called as declaration. So here in this interface, basically in any interface, okay, we will just declare the methods. We will not define them. Okay. I will explain why it is going to be like that. Okay. It's a skeleton of a class. Here we just declare the methods. Okay. We will not define them. Now, for example, say if we take a car. Okay. Again, we know that car is going to have a methods like move forward, move backward, and then stop. Say I just declare the methods. Say assume in this car interface, say I just declare the methods here. Okay. Now everyone observe, there will be a class like BMW car. Now this is a class. So this is assume this is the interface. This is a class. So say here in this BMW car, everyone try to understand my statements. In this BMW car, I'm implementing this interface car. Okay. See here. Implementing the car interface. What does it mean? Say the mechanism in BMW car for moving forward. Say any car generally will have the same features, right? It might be a BMW, it might be a Benz, it might be a Hyundai, it might be any car. These are the common things, right? It might be any car. These are the common things. But the mechanisms will be different. Say the BMW car, it has its own way. Okay. And Hyundai car, it has its own way. The mechanism, the internal mechanism will be different. But the way is different. The overall functionality is same, right? It might be any car. You are going to have these kind of functionalities. Now here, that is where I am just declaring here. I am saying that car is going to have these kind of functionalities. Okay. Now here, in this BMW car class, I am implementing these functionalities here. So here I will write move forward. Okay, here implementing in the sense I will define it. Whatever the methods that we have here, whatever the methods that has been declared in the interface, we are going to define here as per the BMW car specifications. Okay, so let me say this. All the methods on the declared methods in interface will be defined here. Okay, so I'm saying that this BMW car, I'm implementing this car interface means, so whatever the methods that is being declared here, those methods will be defined here. So how it is going to be defined? Define as per the BMW. Okay, some BMW has its own way, it has own technology, right? So as per the BMW technology, these functionalities will be implemented, will be defined here. Okay, so in a similar way, say if we talk about a Hyundai car, say this is again a car, say I am saying that there is kind of implements car interface. It means again that what I will do, all the declared methods in the interface will be defined here as per the HUMAI technology. So if I say this, again what will say? As per Honda. Okay. So what I am saying here basically, here these functionalities are common. It might be a Hyundai, it might be a BMW, it might be a Honda, any car. These functionalities are same. But the way it is different, I mean based on the type of the car, for BMW car it has its own technology, for Hyundai it has its own technology, Honda its own technology. Okay, but ultimately all of them are moving forward, moving backward, starting and stopping, all the functionalities will be there, but the way is different. That is where here we mention the interface commonly, and we are trying to establish a common names here. Everyone try to understand the methods will be the functionality names we have listed down, and the method names will be same here. Okay, even in this BMW car you'll have the same kind of same methods names will be there. But the internally the logic will be different. As the technology is different, so the internal logic will be different. But this BMW car and this Hyundai car and this Honda car, these classes are going to contain the same methods name here. Same methods are going to be there in these classes, but the internal logic will be different. Okay, any questions on this concept? Before we move further, any questions on this concept that we have been discussing, like this car interface and this classes, any questions over here? See here, just assume you don't have the concept of interface. Just assume you don't have the concept of interface. In that case, we will have three classes here, BMW car, Hyundai car, Honda car. Okay. Now here we know that BMW car is going to move forward, move backward. But probably here the method names will be like this. I can see that move forward some BMW. I may mention something in this. Okay. Here in Hyundai car, maybe probably I will mention Hyundai move forward. Okay. There won't be any kind of a standardization. Okay. Of course, you can write your own methods, but the thing is, we don't have any standardization. Okay, here I am writing my own method name. Okay, here I am writing my own method name. Okay, basically we are not going to have any standardization. However, why the standardization is going to be required? Yes, we are going to practically understand how it is going to be helpful. Okay, now we are actually getting into our Selenium Webdriver. Now let us move to our Selenium Webdriver. So I have been talking about what is meant by interface, and I am trying to give an example over here. Now in a similar way, here we understood that there is a interface called car, and there are three classes. Okay, these are the three classes which are going to be implement what are the methods that are there in this interface. Okay, in a similar way, when we say Selenium Webdriver, okay, which is nothing but it's a browser. When I say Selenium Webdriver means it's basically a browser. Let me say it's a browser. Okay. When I say Selenium Webdriver, web means web-based application. Driver means it's a kind of a driving thing. Generally, it's going to be represent a browser. Okay. So here, what we can do in a browser, it might be. See, when I say browser means It might be Internet Explorer, it might be a Google Chrome, it might be a Firefox, it might be a Netscape, okay, it might be any browser. In any browser, what are the general operations that we do? Any guesses? In any browser, it might be any browser, any type of browser, what are the operations that we do in a browser? Yes. Here we can launch our, if that's correct, Harita. Okay, we can search. I'm not talking about in terms of functionality of our application. I'm talking about in general things that we do in a browser. The first thing is when you open a browser, you can open a URL, right? Open a URL or application. Say, once I open Firefox, say I want to open a gmail.com, right? Yes, that's correct, Merlin. We can select a value and drop down. Okay, or a radio button. Okay. And if that's correct, Devon, yes, we can maximize or minimize a browser. Any other guesses? Yes, that's correct, Merlin. Here, if you have any text field, we'll enter. Now, everyone up there, we have opened a browser here. So, here, first thing is, we are opening a browser here, right? We are going to open an application here. Okay. So, say for example, I'm opening a dealforloans.com here. Okay. I can open this dealforloans.com. It might be a Firefox. It might be Internet Explorer. It might be a Google Chrome. Any browser we can open this application, right? So, it might be Internet Explorer. Again, there we'll have a URL section. In that URL section, we'll mention this dealforloans. Okay. So here in a browser, what we can do, we can open a URL. Simply, I can see we can open a URL. Okay, we can select a value. It means if you have any application, if you have any dropdown, here what you can do, this is your browser, right? Here you are going to select a value from this list box. Okay, here you are going to enter a value here. This is a text box. In text box, you can enter a value. If you have any button, you can click on that button. If you have any link, you can click on a link. So what are the things that we are performing? It might be any browser, it might be Google Chrome, it might be Internet Explorer. These are some set of operations, right? We can open a browser, of course, even we can close a browser. Right? We can open an application, we can select a value, we can maximize or minimize the browser, we can enter a value into a text box, we can click, okay, we can close. If you closely observe these operations, these things, we can perform these operations in any browser, right? It might be Internet Explorer, it might be Firefox, it might be Google Chrome. Okay. Is there anyone that you want to disagree with this? Do you agree with this? I'm saying it might be any browser. Okay. These are the operations. Do you agree with this? Any questions on this? Now see here, if you talk about the Internet Explorer, okay, so here Selenium Webdriver basically interface, okay, Selenium Webdriver is the interface, and here in this interface, these are the different operations will be declared, okay, not defined. Now see here, these operations will be declared. Okay, it will not be defined. In Internet Explorer, these operations has been defined. Okay, all the methods of WebDriver, Selenium WebDriver has been defined. Okay, in IE. Why I have to exclusively define in IE and why I have to exclusively define in Firefox? Because it might be any browser, where basically we are opening an application, we are selecting a value in a drop down, we are maximizing or minimizing, it might be any browser, we are entering a value, right? Why we have to like define exclusively in Internet Explorer, exclusively define in Firefox? Any guesses? I mean, any guesses from the new students? Why we have to do this? Because these are all the common operations. Okay, it might be any browser. That's correct, Merlin. Yes, Merlin give a good answer. Yes, that's correct, Anil. You're getting into track. Now, see, let me copy the guesses here. Any other guesses from anyone? See here. Yes, each browser performs differently. That is correct. You know, technically, as an end user. Okay, see here. When I look at this application, it seems to be same. It might be in Internet Explorer, it might be in Firefox. But why the different browsers are coming into picture? Because each browser performs differently. I know most of the people says that Google Chrome is going to be very fast application. Why? When you do some operation, the understanding of the Google Chrome will be very fast than this. So technically, internally, within the browser, there will be some different operations. See here, I'm entering a value here in Firefox in an application. Say here I'm entering some value here. Okay. So when I enter this value, the way of interpretation, the Firefox, it will understand in a different way, whereas in Internet Explorer, it is going to understand in a different way. Okay. So each browser understand it in a different way. So that is where here. In Selenium, here we are going to have different implementations. Okay. So Firefox Internet Explorer has going to define these methods by its own way. Firefox is going to be defined its own way, and Google Chrome by its own way. Okay. And Netscape. And apart from this, there is something called HTML unit driver. We'll discuss more details about this. HTML unit driver means it's basically again a browser which is not going to have any GUI. It means Internet Explorer means we know this. This is an Internet Explorer, and we know that this is a Firefox. In a similar way, you will not have any UI. In the sense, for each and every browser, we will have an interface. We can see them, but whereas the HTML unit driver, we cannot see it. Okay, it happens, it is a virtual browser. Okay, it happens in the background. We will discuss these things in coming classes. So ultimately, what I am trying to explain here in Selenium Webdriver, if you remember, I hope everyone was there in the demo session, right? Everyone was there in the demo session, right? During the demos, we were trying to execute our script on multiple browsers. We were recorded on the Firefox, and then we are trying to execute in Google Chrome, right? Is anyone who did not attend the demo? I mean, for those people who attended the demo, if you remember, we recorded the script on Firefox, and then we were trying to execute the script in Google Chrome, right? Did you remember that? So what is happening? Because of this same methods has been used, because the same methods have been used across all the types of browsers. What you have to do here, you have to simply change one or two lines where your instantiation is going to be changed. I mean, say if you want to open Firefox, okay, you are going to write appropriate logic. And after that, whatever you perform on the Firefox, the same types of methods will be there in all the browsers, right? So say if you want to execute you prepared your script in Firefox, and if you want to execute in Internet Explorer, you don't need to change anything in your script, only one line, because you are using a standard method names. You are using the standard method names across all the types of browsers. The only difference is, instead of opening a Firefox browser, you are going to change the logic that instead of opening Firefox, I want to open a Google Chrome. Only that. You will change only that particular logic. You don't need to change anything else. Okay. So this is the main advantage of Selenium Webdriver. Okay, this is the main advantage of the Selenium Webdriver. That is where why Selenium Webdriver got clicked, and it is getting more demand because of this reason. Okay, it seems to be have same methods across the browsers. Okay, of course it is going to have the same methods across the browsers, but Internet Explorer is going to contain the same methods, but by its own way. Okay, in Internet Explorer it has been defined by its own way. In Firefox it has been defined by its own way. In Google Chrome it has been defined its own way, so that there won't be any much differences, many difficulties. But in the earlier, if you remember, I said there was a Selenium RC. I hope everyone remembers Selenium RC, Selenium Remote Control. I said this is the older version and now it has been deprecated. What happened in Selenium RC, irrespective of the browser type, they try to use the same methods. In Selenium RC, irrespective of this browser types, at that time they have defined only one class, say Selenium RC, and they have defined all these methods. Okay, all these methods. And for these methods, they were trying to execute all these things with a single method name. I mean, they don't have any breakup like this. They have simply a click, and they thought that this click is going to be work for Internet Explorer and Firefox and Google Chrome. In Selenium RC, who has developed that? They had a perception that when we have mentioned click. In Selenium RC, the perception was that if you use click is going to be same in Internet Explorer, Firefox and Google Chrome or whatever it might be. Okay, it has a perception that. Okay, but in Selenium Webdriver, now they have realized that click is going to be different in Internet Explorer, it is going to be different in Firefox, okay, it is going to be different in Google Chrome. Okay, as they have realized it, they come up with Selenium Webdriver logic. Okay, so that is where while explaining this introduction class, whenever we come across Selenium Webdriver versus Selenium RC, okay, probably at that time I would have skipped it. I said going forward in coming classes we will discuss that difference between Selenium RC and Selenium Webdriver. This is the technical difference. Okay, the difference between Selenium RC and Selenium Webdriver is this. Selenium RC, where they had a perception that each and every method, each and every operation will be common across the browsers. After that, in Selenium Webdriver, they realize that in each and every browser operations, the names will be same, but the way of implementation is different. So accordingly, they have implemented a concept like this. Okay. So we have been talking about the Selenium Webdriver interface. Okay. So in our next class, we are going to create a first Selenium Webdriver code. And probably by using a record and export and try to execute from Selenium IDE. Okay, so tomorrow we are going to start from here.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.